Gobi's bones pulse with magic.
It must be Govi. Could we just hold on to it? Maybe we'll find the rest of it.
His spirit lies to you, Billy. I have known many spirits. They are all liars.
This one is different. You
know very little.
Become a dragon, Amir.
Oh, he's no friend of mine.
This little scroat was a constant source of annoyance amongst Aesir and Vanir alike.
Then why free him?
Trust the recently liberated brother. No one deserves to be held captive like him.
Never answered the boy's question there. How did this dwarf become a dragon?
I don't know for certain, though I'd wager his penchant for stealing magical artifacts had something to do with it. Must have stolen a trinket from the wrong Vanir goddess.
Time to set him free. Think he'll remember you?
I don't know, lad. A lot's changed since we last crossed paths. I had legs. A wee little bugger. Well, the dragon hasn't done much for his personality.
Trusting a spirit to keep its word is foolish, boy.
But if there's even a chance, don't you want to see Mom again?
Of course I. She is gone, Atreus. You must accept this.
I do, but to see her again, just one more time.
Why do you believe him? You do not know him or who he was. All of this is sinister.
He wants to see someone he loved again. I understand how that feels. I don't think there's anything sinister about it.
Hope is blinding your instincts, boy.
We've seen these runes before, but it's the kind I still can't read. Almost. If we could just find the other pieces of the language disc. I can't translate this without the whole cipher.
Once you retrieve the whetstone, please take utmost care while handling it. It is a priceless relic, after all.
Ilad, the Council of Valkyries.
The Valkyries are of Valhalla, are they not?
Glad to see you're paying attention, brother. You are correct. Valhalla, the Great Hall of the Einherjar, is their home within Asgard. But while there, they are subject to the scrutiny of the Allfather himself. And relations between the Valkyries and Odin were tense during my tenure as his advisor.
Why?
Well, that's an even longer story, lad. For now, why don't we look around for some clues? Gunnar, Mistress of War. After any conflict, big or small, she would be first on the scene, sussing out the worthy spirits for a free trip to Valhalla. A gruesome task, but she took great pride in it.
Any conflict? Impossible.
It's true. She had help from her sisters, of course, but Gunnar was always first to arrive. Her judgment of the fallen was unparalleled, and an invaluable resource to Odin. She was one of his favorites. This is none other than Geirdrifu, the Master of Arms in Valhalla, responsible for arming and training Odin's Einherjar.
His what?
His army, come Ragnarok. The entire reason Valhalla exists, you see. The Einherjar wait in the Great Hall endlessly, feasting, drinking, and fornicating themselves silly. Once Ragnarok begins, Odin calls them into service to fight on his behalf. Geirdrifu had her hands full training that lot. This, my friends, is Kara. Now, Valkyries are volatile by nature, But Kara, the lass is Wildstorm personified.
A Wildstorm?
Aye, calm and collected. Then the air would shift and the fury of her storm would unleash. It was beautiful in a way, assuming you could find proper shelter. Her tears would cleanse the blood-soaked battlefields. This is Rota, a chooser of the slain.
I thought all the Valkyrie did that.
Not exactly, lad. Although that is what they're most famous for, and by far their greatest responsibility. You've seen what happens to the dead without the judgment of the Valkyries.
Hellwalkers.
That's right. Rota, Gunnar, Skuld. Without them to clean up the aftermath of battle, Hell overflows with souls meant for Valhalla. A sorry state of affairs. Rota must be beside herself. Once the daughter of a powerful chieftain, she fell defending him during a Reaver attack. Olrun was escorted to Valhalla, where she chose to devote her afterlife to the pursuit of knowledge above all else. Quite unusual behaviour amongst the constant drinking and feasting of her fellow Valhallian denizens.
How'd she end up a Valkyrie?
Odin. He saw a kindred spirit in Olrun's single-minded pursuit of knowledge. He appointed her as a Valkyrie's resident historian.
I need that alchemist for something I'm stewing up for you. If you're smart, you'll find him.
Atreus, to me.
Okay, I'm coming.
Was I then?
You'd become Odin's most trusted advisor.
Aye. I never claimed to be perfect, laddie. Only clever. And often too clever by half.
So what'd you do to get Odin so mad at you?
Well, for a long time my job was to enable Odin, and I was fucking excellent at it. Gradually, as I grew more to care about people and the world, my job became to contain him. To protect him from himself. By serving peace, I served his interests as well. That's the truth. But he saw it as disloyalty. No longer trusting my motives, but not wishing to part with my brain or tongue, he bound me to a tree and adopted a new pastime of casual torture.
Well, I'm glad we came along to cut off your head.
Aye, lad. Lucky break that was. join up.
Boy.
Sir.
Kavikia.
Here we go!
This does more than decipher those Muspelheim runes. It also contains the travel rune. Should we go visit the fire realm?
Thank you.
I can read what this says now. But it's a name.
Air! Whoa! The name made it light up.
It's the name of one of the Valkyries. That's quite curious.
That out.
Here. But is that snow?
Ash. It only falls like that for great fires.
The whole realm is a great fire. The source of fire itself. And all the sun and stars, if legend is to be believed.
Should we believe? I mean, we're here, and we're not on fire.
Not yet.
Well, you know, I suppose it's cooled considerably since the dawn of creation, hasn't it? Niflheim isn't exactly ice these days either. It's in the nature of things. Extremes are tempered by time. Fires burn colder, men grow old and grey. Heads are chopped off and attached to belts. Such is life.
Okay, Mimir. You must like the heat, Brock.
Heat's damned useful in my line of work. Even makes space itself more pliable. Take those magic doors you love so much. Round here, they all go right to one another. No prodding from old Brock. Go up yonder and wake some up. You'll see.
Here, boy. Another one.
This one's called Surtur. Must be a fire giant.
Aye. The first and original.
He makes a flaming sword.
A weapon of legend.
He fights Thor and Odin. But is that the past or the future?
That may be a matter of perspective.
Listen, I hear a voice.
Another elf?
I don't think so. It's coming from up there. The voice! It's just around this corner. Oh. It's a great big sword. It wants to know if we're ready to train?
Prepare yourself, boy.
Yes, sir.
It'd be nice to find some incense just once. The smell of brimstone gets old quickly.
level to this challenge.
Harder than before.
Be ready, boy.